After a prolonged closure, the Katuna border crossing was reopened on March 7, 2022, allowing passenger vehicles to pass between Uganda and Rwanda. Business owners breathed a sigh of relief. Peter Gwikiakare, the Southwestern Regional Manager for Customs at the Uganda Revenue Authority, expressed optimism that the resumption of full border operations would enhance trade and strengthen bilateral relations between the two countries.
Advice to the traders and any other person who wants to transact trade across the border is that endeavor to comply to the requirements of the Rwanda government.
Gradually, cross-border movement began to take shape, with people embracing the resumption of traffic. On April 19, 2023, a celebratory event called Rukunde Gumaho was held in Kabale district to mark the reopening of the Rwandan borders with Uganda. The function was attended by guests from both countries, and the atmosphere was filled with excitement. However, beneath the surface of this positive development, questions lingered about the state of affairs at the border. Were the good old days really back? Keren Rwangabo, a businesswoman and a landlady at the border, recounted how her businesses had thrived before the border closure. The reopening did not help it recover. Rwangabo laments that Rwandan buyers who used to frequent her shop vanished.
I used to sell nails for construction, iron sheets, household furniture, mattresses, and so many other items. Business was really booming back then.
During my visit at the border, it happened to be the weekly market, previously known as the World Market. It used to buzz with traders and buyers from Uganda and Rwanda. However, I was surprised to find a lackluster market with only a handful of traders.
Those days, you'd find this market full of vendors from both Uganda and Rwanda. It was called the World Market, and some traders from Uganda had shifted from Kampala to do business here.
Traders at Katuna shared their stories of struggling businesses with no significant improvement even after the border reopened.
The customers we get from Rwanda these days come in through porous borders, and when they buy items here, they hide them to avoid being held by security back home. Those days, I would return here and make a lot of money in just one day. I would earn between 500,000 and 700,000 shillings. But now, I cannot even make 100,000 shillings.
More locals recounted the ongoing challenges they face while doing businesses at the border.
Those days, we would be very busy making money because the Rwandans would bring francs here. At times, we would miss meals because we were earning. But now, you can spend days without any coin coming your way.
On the other hand, truck drivers highlighted the positive impact of using the Katuna border once again. It improved their work conditions.
Now, I think it's not bad at all. It's okay. We are coming, we are crossing very well.
Elvis Nzeirwe, the Katuna Town Council LC3 chairperson, says business has remained slow due to restrictions on small-scale traders in Rwanda.
Restrictions still in Rwanda, whereby the natives of Rwanda are not crossing to Uganda. So, like these people, the traders who trade in small scales, they are not coming because of those charges.
Nzeiru explains that only a few vendors who pass via porous borders can conduct transactions in Katuna.
Border, there are so many porous borders where the Rwandese are trespassing through. So they don't pass through the customs, they just pass through those porous borders, bringing the beans, the kitchen, the chickens, and some other small items.
The future of business at Katuna border town remains uncertain. Some of the previously vibrant shops remain closed. Traders here can only pray that someday business will return to normal. For Urban TV News, I am Job Namanya.